Totochan's name. Totochan's real name was Tetsuko. Before she was born, all mothers and daddy's friends and relatives said that they were sure the baby would be a boy. It was their first child, and they believed it. So they decided to name the baby Toru. When the baby turned out to be a girl, they were a bit disappointed, but they both liked the Chinese character of Toru, which means to penetrate, to carry far, to be clear and resonant as a voice. So they made it into a girl's name by using its Chinese-derived pronunciation Tetsu and adding the suffix Ko, often used for girls' names. So everybody called her Tetsuko-chan. Chan is the familiar form of the san used after a person's name. But it didn't sound quite like Tetsuko-chan to her. Whenever anyone asked her what her name was, she would answer Totto-chan. She even thought that Chan was part of her name too. Daddy sometimes called her Totsukai, as if she were a boy. He didn't say Totsukai. Come and help me take those bugs off the roses. But except for Daddy and Rocky, everybody else called her Totto-chan. And although she wrote her name as Tetsuko in her notebooks at school, she still went on thinking of herself as Totto-chan. Radio comedians. Yesterday Totto-chan was very upset. Mother had said, "You mustn't listen to any more comedians on the radio." When Totto-chan was a little girl, radios were large and made of wood. They were very elegant. Theirs was rectangular with a rounded top and a big speaker in front covered with pink silk and carved arabesques. It had two control knobs. Even before she started school, Totto-chan liked to listen to Rakugo comedians, pressing her ears against the pink silk. She thought their jokes were terribly funny. Mother had never objected to her listening to them until yesterday. Last night, some of Daddy's friends from the orchestra came to their house to practice strings quartets in the living room. Mr. Tetsunenda Tachibana, who plays the cello, has brought you some bananas, said mother. Totto-chan was thrilled. She bowed politely to Mr. Tachibana and, by way of thanks, exclaimed to her mother, "Hey ma, this is pretty goddamn good." After that, Totto-chan had to listen in secret when mother and daddy were out. When the comedians were good, she would laugh uproariously. If any grown-ups had been watching, they might well have wondered how such small girl could understand such difficult jokes. But there's no doubt that children have an innate sense of humor. No matter how young they are, they always know when something's really funny.